Good evening and welcome to the sixth episode of the Thursday Table. Today, we are fortunate to have with us Dr. Prashant Uthage, a renowned pediatric neurologist. Dr. Prashant is a consultant at Uthage Institute for Child Neurology, Epilepsy and Rehabilitation in Hyderabad. He's also a guest faculty at National Institute for Empowerment of Persons with Intellectual Disabilities and DNB teacher, Kamineni Hospital, Hyderabad. Dr. Prashant has a fellowship in pediatric neurology from Wadia Hospital for Women and Children, Mumbai, DNB Pediatrics from Durgabai Deshmukh Hospital, Andhra Mahila Sabha, Hyderabad, and MBBS from MIMSR Medical College, Latur, Maharashtra. Dr. Prashant has many accomplishments to his credit. He published the first case report of familial acute necrotizing encephalopathy with novel genetic mutation and the first case report of PNP deficiency, a novel mutation from India. He's an associate member of the Board of Genetics, Telangana, and his special interest is in autism. With this brief introduction, I welcome Doctor to this program.
Hi, good evening all. Am I audible now?
Yes, Doctor, you are.
Hi, thanks, madam, for kind introduction. Now it is suddenly decided that we will speak on general health and wellness. And luckily me and Dr. Umesh, I think, started to concentrate on our own health being a doctor since last 1.5 years. So I was just searching for my photo, which was there in 2016, and now there are drastic changes. I'll just try to get it while presenting this. So I'll share my screen. Before going this, I just want to know what is our audience? A few of our patients also want to join, so I ask them, their parents, they may be joining. But along with that, just I want to, so that we can focus on the topic, what actually our this one.
We're mainly doing for the junior college students, that is the 11th and 12th grade. And we have 180 of them watching you on the big screen.
Okay. So shall I start?
Yes. Yes, Doc.
My screen is visible?
Yes, it is.
So guys, I'm Dr. Prashant Uthage, and I'm mainly working in the field of child neurology, child development, and it is not limited to only child, but it is the overall development of the human being till, which is, we can say it is a base of anyone, like junior college or adolescent or adult. So in this talk, I'm mainly focusing on what is mean by general health, what is mean or actual definition of the wellness, then what are the aims and how to achieve for our general health and wellness. Then what is the take home message after this? To start with, as I shared just now, to share my own story, if you see here, till the lockdown, usually the doctors life, as you know, it's always hectic, always busy, and they give message to the community that we should keep our health very up to date. Okay, but unfortunately, we maximum doctors, the recent survey in the lockdown shows that around 30 to 60% doctor themselves are unable to concentrate on their general health and well-being, and there is a more incidence of hypertension, diabetes, and cardiac complication more into the doctor. So considering that, I myself did changes into my life, which I'll be sharing in a subsequent page. Before moving to this, I want to just show you the slide. So can anyone tell what is mean by actually wellness? Is it an interactive session, madam?
No, they're just watching on the screen.
Okay, so they
we
will
give them an option to ask questions at the end of this.
Okay, so see, when we say it is a health or a wellness, it consists of around 8 parameters. And to relate with it is a emotional health, then what is your intellectual health and physical health, means it is a external appearance. Then social health, environmental, financial and spiritual. So wellness or a health means you need to get settled or well accustomed with all these 8 parameters. So now moving towards first parameter, that is the physical health. So how should we go ahead and keep us healthy or physically fit? So we need to have the first for the physical health is the physical activity. So in that, if you see now, to show you, this is now with a busy hectic schedule, me and our batchmate like Umesh try to keep the healthy activity early morning. So for student, it is very important nowadays because of the evolution of the digital media. Everyone want to be there on a digital platform. They will be on a social media. So the sleep pattern will get disturbed. And once you see the screen of the mobile tab or TV or any digital media, your sleep will get postponed by 1.5 hours. Okay. So it is very important to take care of your physical and mental health. And for that, the most foremost rule is use the digital screen as and when required, not the extensively, when it is required for your education purpose, when it is required for your social life, but it should be limited. So your digital screen usage should be very limited and in a useful manner. Second thing, sleep pattern or a sleep hygiene, which nowadays like we can't say kid, but it's overall adolescent and a college going student, that doesn't much focus on a sound sleep. Sound sleep means when you close your eyes, your mind should be sleeping at that time. If you don't have the sound sleep, if you don't get up early morning in a fresh way, it affects your cognition, means your concentration capacity, your attention and your grasping power. Now during our college life or this like junior college or senior college, whatever, when you are studying, you require your mind to be very, very attentive and focusing. And for that, what we require is the proper and sleep, which is a hygienic sleep. So what are the tips to get the proper hygienic sleep? That you should be avoiding using the screen at least 1.5 or 2 hours before your sleep timing, and preferably it should be a physiological sleep. And a physiological sleep, if you see the duration is around 6 to 8 hours during the this college period or active period. So if you see the previous pattern, even at our time that we used to sleep early at around 10:30 and up early morning by 5:30 for our studies. So this is a physiological period, and this gives you a window of the meditation if you get up early in the morning, that is around 5:30. Nowadays 4 o'clock, we can't say at our time it was 4 o'clock, but at present time the time frame has shifted to 5:30. Then what you need to start your day with, either yoga, either meditation, or whatever the activity you prefer, let it be cycling, let it be running, let it be walking, let it be swimming, or let it be horse riding or any kind of activity. But physical, now we are moving towards the physical activity for your physical well-being. So if you want to keep your day healthy and to grasp more, you have to start with the physical activity, which I have mentioned. And the same thing, when I am giving you the lecture, I follow the same thing to focus this. This is the image, like we go for the cycling minimum 30-35 kilometers in a day. And these are, even I go for my visiting place like Latur, that is my hometown, I make sure that I should follow my schedule. And this is the video which I am sharing you, that in spite of rain, whether it is a summer, winter or anything, we should follow our commitment of getting up early morning and following the schedule. And this is the activity which I follow while doing my activity. So why I have put this slide, because just to show that even it is a raining, it is a complete summer or it is a winter, we should follow our daily healthy activity in our daily schedule. Now this is called as a physical well-being. Then second one is the emotional well-being, where we need to feed our brain with all good thoughts, which gives you the positive energy throughout the day. And how to do that? Like, you need to reinforce your mind with all positive thoughts, like always positive attitude, especially during the college life. To give my example, when I was appearing for my final exams in the DNB, which is a tough exam, around 400 people from all over country appeared. Out of that, only 30 students has passed, and I was one of them. But in this, during this exam period or on a daily basis also, you need to have the emotional stability. Means definitely everyone will study hard when you come to the intermediate, once you clear your 10th and then intermediate first and second. But everyone want to dream of big, that okay, I'll get the 98% or 100%. But no one want to study or give dedication, hard efforts for that aim. So for that, you need to have the proper dedication time and then positive output. Like, you should be working very hard from morning to, like we used to study for around 15 to 18 hours. And I mean it, that's how we could achieve the our position at present, what we are in socially. So what is required, as I said, first is the physical one, which we have already seen. Second one, emotional stability, that means you have to feed your mind, that is the emotional health, with a positive thought that, okay, I'm aiming for this, like to become a engineer, which is, and to get the topmost rank in our field. But at the same time, you have to work hard for that. Then spiritual, as I said, in early morning, when you go for the yoga, meditation and positive feeding, definitely your energy output during this youth period will be more. Financial, I don't talk much, because this is for guys who have already completed their education and they are going for the, but this is one of the most important part to keep you well or healthy. Then environmental, how should be the environment? Like, try to keep be in the natural environment, like to take the early morning when you go to the park. Obviously, it gives you the positive energy of the natural things. Then the social well-being, like you should be during this period, you should be always in a touch with friends who are always give you the positive input, not getting diverted, because this is a very crucial period of the brain development, where we need to focus on your aim. There will be a many divergent factor, like attraction towards the opposite sex, at the same time getting attracted towards the like habits, like it may be smoking, it may be the drinking, it may be the other factors. But if you have the good social company where they are focusing on their aims and objectives, then definitely you'll be able to focus what you want. So we need to see that your wellness, it's at the same time depends upon your social and environmental factors, like your friends and the environment which you are living in. Now this is, I'm stopping sharing my screen. want to have how should we go towards the nutritional now? So most important factor is the diet. So what we should include? If you see my schedule before lockdown, like I realized how human life is important. My schedule was to share with morning 8 o'clock day start and night 12 o'clock. So I used to have my breakfast or lunch at 1:30. Ideally, we should have our starting of the day breakfast should be like a king, as everyone knows. Our lunch should be like a normal human being, and our dinner should be like a beggar, they say. So our day should start with heavy breakfast with lot of proteins and fruits and more of veggies. Afternoon lunch should be medium quality with your proteins and all veggies. And evening after 6:30, you should not be able to like just have the juice or one roti. But now the schedule with the Metro City availability, KFC, burgers, and Diet Coke, Pepsi has changed totally. Even I used to eat late night once I finished my OP by 12:30, and then I used to go out, okay, late night dinner kahan pe hota hai, biryani kahan pe hota hai, let us search for that. But this is not correct at all. The physiological pattern that you should be stopping eating after like before 7 o'clock, you should be able to take evening. And after that, light juice or fruits should be there. So for youth, it's very, very important to keep your diet healthy, and the pattern should be 3 to 4 times, or whatever pattern you follow, there has to be fixed timing, whatever your schedules. So diet plays major role in your health and then your well-being. Now, second thing, as I already mentioned, the physical health, where you need to have your yoga or meditation or dance or your cycling or your horse riding or whatever things. So you should be following one physical activity in the morning for half an hour, 30 minutes, 45 minutes or 1 hour. And evening, maybe the brisk walk will be sufficient. This gives you a strength to focus on your aim, focus on your study, focus on your work. So this is of the second thing, that is the physical parameter. Third thing is now how to motivate yourself to keep your mental health healthy. So you need to have the positive reading habits, which is very important. I think madam also will be able to like say reading at our time. Now as media is available, we are just clicking it up and just watching the video. But reading will give you, as I'm working in a child development, it gives you a lot of positive input. Whatever the reading, let it be the motivational, let it like financial books or whatever. But you should have the habit of reading either newspaper or positive thinking books on this. So that this gives you the stability for the mental health. Then social health, obviously you will be having interaction with good people, those who are very excellent in your field, let it be like you're one of the good professor. In our field, we interact with our educationists. Like if I am practicing in a child neurology, I'll try to interact with our international speakers who are working in a field of autism, cerebral palsy, child development. Okay. So these are the few tips, I think, to keep you well and healthy in physical, mental, emotional, spiritual, then financial, and then on all other ways. So here, I think I'll finish my talk, and I want this not like a talk, but it should be a more of an interactive session, because this is the period, crucial period, you need a good motivator or one inspirational person in your life. So thank you. Thanks, everyone.
Children, if you have any questions, you can ask now.
And I don't always want it is an interactive session, but sorry, I could not make many slides because of my tight schedule. That's what I asked madam yesterday, to make the slide. It will take a little bit long time, but it has been a busy day. But we can always interact, those who are your student or any question like you want to want me to explain on a particular topic. It is a very vague topic, and a lot can be like 4 or 5 hours we can speak on this.
Myself, Abdul Hannan from Senior MPC. Sir, can you please explain what is meant by anemia?
Can you be a little bit clearer? I got to came to know mental, but
he wants to know what is anemia.
Okay, anemia. See, anemia is when your hemoglobin drop down less than expected normal value. For Indian overall international standard, it is for male it is more than 14. The value of the hemoglobin should be more than 14. And in females, it is anything above less than 12, we call it as anemia. When your diet consists of low iron, then low green leafy vegetables, you are not taking rich source of iron, it causes the anemia. Anemia is any hemoglobin less than 10, we call it as anemia. But when it goes to critical level, like less than 6, then it, we need 6 or 4, we need a blood transfusion. But low anemia or low hemoglobin itself was a problem with the learning, attention, and concentration. Now, how to diagnose it? Simple blood test, which causes CBC, complete blood count, will give you idea of hemoglobin. And so this is for the diagnosis. But for the treatment, you should be eating more green leafy vegetables, then beetroot, tomato, then the vegetable which you should make, it should be an iron pot. Jaggery is the richest source of iron again. So these are the things which you can prevent once we diagnose to have the anemia. If you include, see, there are artificial sources taking the medication and syrups or tablet, but these are the natural sources. If you include this into your daily routines, you won't get the low hemoglobin or anemia. But this is the commonest cause of learning disability or a school dropout or low attention in Indian students or Indian parents. Low hemoglobin. We call it as anemia. And definitely it affects the mental health, the cognition, then attention capacity, concentration, and definitely it affects your studies.
Yes, can we have the next question, please?
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, this is Mukhtar from Senior MPC. Sir, I have a question. As we know, the present situation is going on corona and all. So most of them saying that if your immunity is weak, the corona effect will be more. So can you advise us to how to improve our immunity system?
Now this is very important question which I want to highlight. At present, I usually see 50 patients in a day, and I am dealing with child development as well as their parents. So because of corona, there is restricted movement. Kids are unable to go out, even adults, and there is no social gathering. So there are the few issues are arising in the kids and adults. There is a ADHD, that is attention deficit. Irritability is more. Behavioral issues are more, and child is developing autism. You may be having the kids which you need to note in your child, there is a speech delay. They are becoming more hyper, they are unable to communicate. And in adult, there is a irritability and continuous use of digital screen or mobile. There are many behavioral issues are coming up in a kid. So first, to keep your healthy and your immunity is to the things which I have advised, the physical health, that is physical activity, then good diet. And in diet, what you need to take care to increase your immunity, which even I follow, is take the yogurt or your curd, which our Indian culture already include the curd or a yogurt into your diet. Second thing is the micronutrient. So like zinc, magnesium, chromium, biotin, how to get it? So sprouts, if you see the intake of our food, doesn't include much sprout. So this gives you the micronutrient and vitamins which keep your immunity healthy. So you need to modify into the diet. If suppose you are unable to do that, then you need to take the multivitamin tablets. But what is advisable is to modify your diet with the sprout, more green leafy vegetables and fruits. These are the richest natural source of micronutrient and vitamin which keep your immunity healthy. You have seen during corona, they advise vitamin C, which can be taken with the lemon juice. You will get it naturally, or an orange, or with the tomato. These are the natural resources and seasonal fruit like mango, banana, they have the richest source of vitamins. That's how we can keep our immunity healthy.
Yes, sir. Next question, please.
Good morning, sir. Myself, Sheikh Idris from MPC. Sir, as we have to prepare for JEE mains and NEET exams, sir, can you suggest us a few tips to increase the memory power?
Yes. Just want to know, because of this digital media, what is your screen time other than your study? No, this is fair question, because see, I'm coming across daily 1 to 2 adolescent coming to me for counseling. Even I go to the bathroom, I carry my mobile and unable to get rid of that. This is the major factor which is affecting the adolescent social media. Let it be Facebook, let it be Instagram, let it be WhatsApp, let it be chat. This is affecting more. So if you restrict your social media, you'll be able to concentrate. This is the recent study. Okay. So if you want to concentrate our attention or more grasping, this digital thing has to be restricted. I'm not saying stop it, because it is required for gaining the knowledge, but if we use it in a proper way. Second thing is the yoga and meditation is very, very important to keep your concentration and attention healthy. And rest of the things like supplement with 3-DHA, vitamin E, and then L-carnosine. These are the artificial things. But at present, what we need is the restriction from the social media till you achieve your goals.
Yes, who wants to ask next?
Good evening, sir.
Hi, good evening.
Sir, as the current situation, we are working from home, due to which our excess weight is increasing. So can you advise us how to reduce our excess weight?
Okay. So let me share my own experience. I have lost around 16 kg in last 1.5 years. Okay. If you search my social media, Prashant.Utage, you'll be able to see my old very chubby face and with lot of tummy. So what is important for weight loss is to make up your mind that, okay, I have to lose my weight. And the most important thing is the physical activity. Let it be the running, cycling, but you should be very committed. I have shown, especially shared my video during like rain also, we continued our cycling. So that much dedication you need, and physical activity is must. And definitely the diet plays major role. You should not be taking all this food items which increases your weight, like especially the lipids and more oily food. And your meal could include the more leafy and green leafy vegetables that keep your weight at the physical activity, and diet plays major role. Physical activity 30%, but diet plays major role. That is, timing of the diet should be fixed, and it should have the more veggies and more fruits. That keep your weight healthy.
Do we have any more questions?
So let me ask one question to all of them. They can type into chat box. What's your screen time other than the your working hours? Honestly, and those who want to cut down that, they can ping me up personally, because see, this is very, very important part which I'm coming across as a practitioner. So they can type into the chat box, what is their screen time other than their working hours, even including madam teachers.
So I will send you if there are any more questions from the children's side. Is it okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So thank you very much, sir, for that very, very informative session. Even though the time I gave you was very brief, I could contact you only yesterday, but still the session was so informative. And anytime, sir, please do come to our campus. It's a very beautiful campus, and we would like to invite you to come here. Thank you very much for the session. Thank you, sir.
So, thank you, ma'am. So next time we'll be prepared with all slides and a little more focus. Yeah. Good.